Hi everybody, me again. New video. Today, going to talk about gun control in the wake of last weekend's terror attack in Las Vegas. Some commentators have been reticent to call it a terror attack, but it is a terror attack. The motives are irrelevant, it's the act itself. Killing 59 people, injuring 500 odd is an act of terror. Whatever reasons, religious, political, whatever you want to do, it's terror. Obviously, here in the UK, we have very stringent gun controls, and you see the amount of people who die through domestic gun violence has been very, very little. Whereas in the US, where they have very little gun control, it seems to be very, very high. The Second Amendment of the American Constitution gives them the right to bear arms, and this is something that can be used by either side to back up their argument. So those who want tighter gun control will cite the Second Amendment and say, well, at the time that was written in the late 18th century, they didn't have automatic weapons or even semi-automatic weapons. They had muskets and swords. Sorry, Peppa Pig blasting out in the background then. Yeah, so the people on the side who want less gun control will say the Second Amendment was non-specific. It says they have the right to bear arms, and it doesn't sort of say, well, you can bear just knives or you can bear just spades and forks and things. No, it's non-specific. You can bear any type of arm, would be their interpretation. One thing that should be clear is that the guns that Stephen Paddock had were actually already illegal. They were legally attained semi-automatic weapons that had been illegally turned to fully automatic weapons. One of the arguments against tighter gun controls is that if the government have the right to hold these automatic weapons, then so should the public. But where do you draw the line? Does that mean that the public have the right to hold, say, nuclear weapons or Agent Orange or whatever other shit they develop in the American military? I don't think it does. The whole point is that you can protect your property, but do you need any more than, say, a pistol to do so if you are going to hold a gun? Do you need something that's going to fire off 40 rounds a second to stop a couple of intruders from, I don't know, raping your bovine livestock, or whatever they do in the deep south, I don't know. There's a level of hypocrisy here as well, because you get a lot of these people who are backing, the current rules of pretty much blanket open gun ownership, who will also be saying, we need to ban all Muslims from the United States because they're all terrorists, backing their president's travel ban. But then someone like Stephen Paddock, who essentially lives the American dream, he's a self-made millionaire, he's white, which, has its inherent values living in America. He's a high roller in Vegas, hence why he was able to afford such a great suite. And he commits the act and they'll say, you can't punish just ordinary gun owners for the acts of a few careless idiots. And I can see that argument, but you have to be consistent. You can't blame all Muslims for the acts of a few cowardly idiots, and you can't blame all gun owners for the acts of a few cowardly innocents. But maybe you have to be consistent about this, and it works both ways, I appreciate, but you have to be consistent. The difference is, though, that the sole purpose of a gun is destruction. The sole purpose of a religion isn't. Say hello. Rude. One statistic that I found quite frightening was that in all the wars that America have ever waged or been involved in, just over 1.3 million Americans have lost their lives. Since 1968, over 1.5 million Americans have lost their lives through domestic gun violence. That's from the New York Times. It's just a frightening statistic, and it's all just to appease people like the NRA, who just want the right to hold whichever exotic weapons they want.
So what is the answer? Well, I personally would have a blanket ban on guns, but I'm not in charge. I'm not silly enough to think that would ever happen in America. So in lieu of that, you would put in place proper gun controls. You would have it so that you couldn't just walk into, you know, Aldi or Lidl or whatever shops they have and buy a Glock or a submachine gun or something. You would have to have a license. You would have to have proper training, so you knew how to maintain and use your gun safely, and just make it harder for people so that the ones who do have it, you've got a better idea of what their motives are for having that weapon. You're never going to avoid utter destruction and acts of terror like we saw in Las Vegas last weekend, unless you do something about it.
It's alright,
if you live the life you please, well, it's alright, doing the best you can, well, it's alright, as long as you lend a hand. You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring, waiting for someone to tell you everything.
R.I.P. Tom Petty.